And now, let's see what's going on down in Pine Ridge. Well, this is Halloween. The old fellows have dropped everything else to join in the activities of the holiday. As we look in on the little community today, it's evening. We find Lum, attired in a ghost costume, knocking on Abner's door. Listen.
Hello? Get away from here, Blue. Get away. Abner, come out here and get this dog before I bust something over his head. Abner, get away from here, Blue. Dad, blame it. You got no sense at all?
Here, Blue, get back under the house there before I beat the daylight out of you. Ain't you ashamed of yourself running out here and barking at folks? Who is it? What do you want?
It's me. That's who it is. Get away from there, Blue. There
well,
he is.
For the land's sake, I never knowed you lumped all that rigging on. Come on in. Let me see how you look.
Well, get that dog back there.
Oh, come on. He ain't gonna bother you.
No, he wouldn't bother you. Wouldn't do no more than take a leg off my fella.
Why, he couldn't bite you if he wanted to. He ain't got a tooth in his head, Lum.
Then he don't need no teeth. Then he bristles up and comes at a fella that way. He scares the daylights out of him.
Oh, he puts up a good bluff. Banners everything that comes on the face.
Well, he ought to have sense enough to know who I am. I've known him ever since he's a pup.
Well, there wouldn't nobody know you in that outfit you got on, Lum. If you ain't a sight, you look like a haint.
I'm a ghost.
Well, you ought to have some horns and whiskers.
Ghost, Abner. G-O-S-T. Ghost, not goat.
Oh, Come on in. Let me look at you.
Ain't you going to the party?
No, I better not go, I reckon. The woman and Papa, they went over there, but I decided I couldn't make it.
Yeah, let me get this pillowcase off my head. I can't see nothing.
You don't look much like a pillar.
I cut some holes in here to see through. This thing slipped around to where they're clean on in the back.
Yeah, I wonder.
Feel my way over here.
Yeah, that's a pretty good get-up you got on there, Lum. I never would have knowed you. I don't believe
you. You wouldn't have. I thought you said this afternoon you was going to the party.
Well, I was sort of aiming on going, but then I got to studying about it and just allowed I better get out here and try to keep some of these boys out of devilment tonight if I could. I don't aim to put up with none of their carrying on tonight. They just might not turn this town upside down as last year, and I don't aim to stand for it again.
Oh, well, they're just having some fun.
Oh, fiddle-faddle.
Halloween don't come up once a year.
That's just once too often, too. If I catch every one of them young'uns doing a thing tonight that he oughtn't to, I'm going to throw him right smack in jail.
Oh, they don't mean no harm, Abner. Let him go. Let him have a good time.
No, sir. I'm the deputy town marshal here, and it's my job to protect folks' property. This thing of just letting young'uns in this community run wild just for this Halloween has got to stop. It's a reflect on my office, that's what it is.
Reflect on your office?
Why, sure it is. Folks will be jumping me all day tomorrow because somebody's took their front gate off or want me to locate a wagon they pulled off or something.
Oh, they don't blame you with it on Halloween night.
They do, too. They'll go look after all their houses and see if the young'uns don't bother nothing while they're gone.
Well, they ought to take it in the Halloween spirit. No use to get mad about it.
Well, they do, though.
Of course, the youngins oughtn't to do no damage to nobody's property. There ain't nothing funny about that. But tick-tacking and carrying jack-o'-lanterns and one thing or another's all right.
I don't see no sense in any of it. Just looks like the youngins here late years have just went plumb hog wild.
I don't know. Is there any worse now than they ever was, Abner?
Ain't no worse.
When most of us was growing up, we was might not as bad.
No. We weren't, No, we weren't.
I don't suppose you recollect who them three boys was that went over to Grandpappy Spears' house when he was having that Halloween party years ago and climbed up on top of the house and laid boards on top of the chimney and smoked everybody out of the house, do you?
What?
Yeah,
I never seen folks pile out of a house so fast in my life with that potato we hunt and me.
That's just who it was.
Hey, don't you know, though, Lum, before we done that, we unhitched the teams that was tied out in front of the house and turned the horses and mules loose right down the big road. Everybody had to walk on.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Oh, it was freezing cold, snowing. Was they mad? That was my idea, I believe. I thought that stung up, I think.
Yeah, you used to be a sight on Halloween.
Oh, I had some good
ideas. Nothing too ornery for you to do that.
No. You recollect the time, Lum, we went over to old Vess's and throwed all his stove wood down the well?
Oh,
Every stick of it.
Poor old Vess had to get up the next morning and borrow wood from his neighbors before it could start a fire.
Funny thing about it, old Vess had to go to the expense to have me well cleaned out. Just ruined his drinking water, my
God. Oh, yeah, he was mad enough to buy it.
Oh, his woman carried water for from the creek for months, sir.
Tried his best to find who done that. Said if you ever found out who done it, he'd loan to the high court.
Yeah, he'd have done it, too. That's just how ornery and cranky that varmint was.
But the funniest thing we ever done, to my notions, was the time we hitched old Doc Murphy's horse up backwards in the shafts to the buggy.
Doc Murphy?
Yeah.
I don't believe I recollect that.
Well, you was there. You had to do it.
Well,
don't you know, we passed by somebody's place and old Doc was making a call there and we had no more and got his horse around backwards in the shafts till he come out the door.
Oh, I recollect now. He never taken no notice it was so dark there. He crawled up there and give that horse a lick with a buggy whip. He run that buggy backwards right into a rail fence. Dumped old Doc right out.
Turned the buggy over and like the broke Doc Murphy's neck.
Oh, he did.
That was mean. Yeah, Doc ought to took that horse whip and give us a good licking for that.
Well, there's another thing, too, little man, I'll tell you. A licking in them days is something you never forgot, Ray. When they give you a whipping, you stayed whipper some time, I'll say that.
I just called to mind, Abner. Next time you slipped old Dad Voss's
feet. Dad Voss, they all sat there at the table eating supper, and we taken a big handful of shell corn and throwed up again in the dining room window like they scared them to death.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about. I never will forget it. Never will forget it.
You know, little Drewer was just fixing to take a drink of milk, and it scared her so bad she throwed that glass right in her grandpa's face.
Well, you know, Dad Voss had a big mouthful of bubble, and Betty likes to choke. Last beating him on the back, had him laying down on the kitchen floor.
Oh, yeah, just a trumpet. And, Romy, doggies, walking over old time this way, might not make me want to get out and do something tonight.
Oh, go around and over little Halloween and stuff like that.
Halloween, I did love it. I'm just a good mind to hunt me up a bunch of boys and join up with them tonight, Lon.
Now, wouldn't you look good out playing us at your age?
What? Nobody would know who it was. What do you say, Lon? Let me get a sheet and dress up like a ghost and we'll both go.
No, sir. Not me. I tried that a few years back.
You did, huh?
Yeah, I was coming back home from a Halloween party one night and met a big bunch of boys pulling somebody's wagon down the road. Said they was going to put it up on top of the schoolhouse, so I told them I'd just go along and help them.
Why, sure.
Sort of brung back old times to me.
Oh, yeah, ain't tried that in ages.
So we taken the wagon all apart and got up on top of the schoolhouse and pulled it up with a rope, piece at a time, set it back up together on top.
I helped do that once. That is a job.
Oh, it taken us might not till daylight the next morning.
Why, sure.
And the funny part of the whole thing, I got up the next morning to hitch up my team and my wagon was gone. I started looking for it and blamed if I hadn't worked all night helping put my own wagon up on top of the schoolhouse.
Well, I do know. That was a good one on you.
You take it all the way around. I don't believe the youngins this day and time are any worse than they was when we was kids growing up.
Well, no, maybe not. Mighty easy to forget when you start getting older. You forget some of the stunts you pulled yourself.
Fact is, I don't believe they're as bad nowadays.
I don't either. They might not be.
They wouldn't do some of the honor things we done.
I don't believe it, no.
They get more civilized, I reckon.
Oh, yeah. They don't tear up property like they used to, I'll admit that. They've learned, I reckon, that they can have just as much fun, maybe more, just playing pranks that don't hurt nobody.
Yeah, that's what I say.
Yeah.
Well, go ahead, your mind all made up to go out and arrest them and throw them the last one of them in jail.
Oh, doggy. Well, I'm proud we got to talking it over. I'm just might not ashamed of myself. I believe I will dress up and go where the party with you, Mom. Just let the young'uns have all the fun they want to tonight. Let them go, I don't care.
Let them hurt. Why, of course not. It'd be a downright shame to bother on Halloween night when they're just playing a little old prank that don't hurt
nothing. Why, sure, I ought to be ashamed of myself for even thinking about it. Yeah, I'll go along with you, Lon, if you don't mind.
Of course not. Come ahead. Be glad to have you.
Yeah, well, just make yourself at home, then. I'll go back here and see if I can find a bed sheet to dress myself up in. No, but I better look around and find a pillowcase that's already got some holes in it, though. Elizabeth about give me a good whooping. She catches me cutting holes in one of her good pillars. I'll find some back here somewhere.
Well, you better wait and put it on after you get out of the yard. That dog of yours will about take in after both of us.
Oh, no, he knows me, Lon. He ain't going. Uh-oh. There goes my ring. Yeah, that's more than likely some smart aleck making a complaint already about these Halloween youngins.
Well, just tell him that you ain't going to bother the youngins.
I'll tell him. Hello? Yeah, this is him, but I... Huh? Oh, yeah, he's sitting right here. Just a minute. Here, Mom, somebody wants you.
Wants me?
That's what they said.
Yes. Hello? Yeah, this is Mom. Oh, hello, Charlie. Happy Halloween.
Right there, Mom poked me out of
that. Yeah.
Mom's a good sport.
Well, dead blame there, Henry Hyde. Charlie, run over there and see if you can find out who any of them is. I'll have Abner come over there and throw the whole bunch of them in jail.
What's that?
Abner, get your coat and hat on. There's a bunch of them ornery boys over there at my place taking my front gate down and hanging it up in a tree.